What is up, guys? Welcome to another Behind the Curve Reacts. As always, if you enjoy the kind of content I'm putting out, feel free to like, comment, subscribe down below, share with your friends, all that good stuff. Consider supporting me on Patreon. You get early access to reactions up there. We do a full musical reaction every month, full Broadway show reaction. It's a lot of fun. And for just $5, I will react to whatever you want. And that's actually what we've got today. One of my newest $5 patrons, Mariana, would like for me to react to the opening number from the show Avenue Q. I've heard, I think it's two songs from this show before. Everyone's a little racist sometimes, and the internet is for porn. Both are just outrageous songs. And the whole thing is done with puppets too, which is crazy to think about. But this is gonna be the opening number from Avenue Q. I don't know what it's called. It might just be called Avenue Q for all I know. But yeah, I am really excited. Like I said, I've heard those two songs, but I don't think that I've ever actually seen them performed. I think I've just heard them. And then I just know from secondary sources that it is done with puppets. One really cool thing too about this is that if it wasn't for Avenue Q, there would be no The Book of Mormon. Okay, so I'm gonna get into just theater history super duper quick here, just because normally I react to stuff that I have no idea what it is, but I know this awesome story of how the Book of Mormon came to be, so I just have to tell you, because we're in my wheelhouse, and I love this. But Trey Parker and Matt Stone, who made South Park, they were making the movie Team America World Police, which was like a secret agent, big budget movie that was completely done with marionette puppets, and it took them forever to do. So they got done with that, and their producer, the South Park guy's producer, Ann Garofino, was like, hey guys, there is this musical on Broadway right now called Avenue Q, and they also use puppets. You guys should go check it out. It's pretty dirty and raunchy, just like you guys love. So they go and watch it, and they look in the Playbill, and in the Playbill, there is actually a thank you from the writer of Avenue Q, I believe the writer of the music, Robert Lopez, thanking Trey Parker and Matt Stone for, like, their work on South Park and, you know, other things had inspired him to do Avenue Q. And they were like, this is crazy. So they met up with Robert Lopez afterwards, he and his wife, who also wrote the music for Frozen, and they, like, had drinks, had dinner. They're like, what? You know, you love Mormons? We love Mormons. Let's write a musical about Mormons. And then 7 years later, The Book of Mormon premiered on Broadway. And the rest is history. I'm sure most of you guys just fast-forwarded right through that, and that's totally fine. But in case you didn't know, that is a tiny little bit of the history of The Book of Mormon. But yeah, I am really excited, so thanks again, Mariana. I really appreciate it. And let's go ahead and get into the opening number of Avenue Q.
Good morning, Brian. How's life?
Disappointing.
What's the matter?
When I was little, I thought I would be
what?
A big comedian on late night TV. But now I'm 32, and as you can see, I'm not.
Nope.
Oh, well.
Nah.
It sucks to be me.
No.
It sucks to be me.
No.
It sucks to be broke and unemployed and turning 33. It sucks to be me.
Well, you think your life sucks?
I think so.
Your problems aren't so bad. I'm kind of pretty and pretty damn smart.
You are.
Thanks. I like romantic things like music and art. As you know, I have a gigantic heart. So why don't I have a boyfriend? It sucks to be me.
Me too.
It sucks to be me.
It sucks to be me. It sucks to be Brian.
And Kate.
To not have a job.
To not have a date.
It sucks to be me.
Come on, it's just $2. I'll pay you back tomorrow.
You wanna know what? You leave your clothes out.
What?
You put your feet on my chair.
Oh, yeah? You do such anal things like ironing your underwear.
You make that very small apartment we share a hell.
So do you. That's why I'm in hell.
It sucks to be me.
No, it sucks to be me.
Oh, Bert Nerney.
It sucks to be me. Is there anybody here? It doesn't suck to be. It sucks to be me.
Da 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 da. You think your life sucks? I'm coming to this country for opportunities. Try to work in Korean, daddy, but I am Japanese. But with hard work, I earned 2 master's degrees in social work. And now I look at a biz, but I have no clients. And I have an unemployed fiance, and we have lots of bills to pay.
For a place to live.
You need to talk to the superintendent.
Yo, Gary!
I'm coming!
Oh my God, it's Gary Coleman!
Yes, I am! I'm Gary Coleman from TV's Different Strokes.
What?
I made a lot of money back, not stolen by my folks. Now I'm broke and I'm the butt of everyone's jokes. But I'm here, superintendent, and I'm here too. It sucks to be you. You win.
I feel better now.
Try having people stopping you to ask you, what you talking about, Willis? It gets old.
It's up to be you. On Avenue Q. On Avenue Q. On Avenue Q. On Avenue Q. But not when we're together. We're together here on Avenue Q. We live on Avenue Q. Our friends do.
Oh man, I gotta watch this whole thing. I have to ask though, it's the same thing with the Spring Awakening death cast. Did they cast people in Avenue Q that could already puppet and just like taught them to sing, or did they cast like Broadway actors and then teach them how to puppet? It's the old Armageddon question. But let's go ahead and get big.
Yeah, this is shaping up to be a show that I absolutely have to watch. I love too that Kate Monster is the same person who has the lead in Scrubs, the musical. Well, the musical episode. If you guys have not seen Scrubs, it's an American medical comedy. And one episode was a whole musical episode because this lady had a like an aneurysm in her head that caused her to see like everybody singing all around her. And it was really fun. But that lady was the actress that played Kate Monster, which is really cool. It's really fun to see that. But I have to ask, though, are there like a bunch of other like Sesame Street homages or ripoffs? Because Bert and Ernie were hilarious. Like, I definitely need to see more Bert and Ernie. But the puppetry was excellent. And it wasn't just like opening your mouth or, you know, opening your hand to move a mouth. I mean, they had like the arms on sticks and stuff. I have no idea how you'd even begin to get that good at controlling them. Because like, they were putting hands on hips to show that you were angry. They were like thinking, they were pointing. That cannot be easy to learn and to make it look that fluid. Like, I was very impressed with really every facet of this show, or at least this number was incredibly well done. And just like the other two songs that I had heard, this one was unbelievably catchy. It was so much fun and such a good like opening number, because you meet, I don't know if it's everybody, but you probably meet like your central cast of characters. Probably like the 7 monsters or the 7 characters, 7 or 8 characters we were introduced to in here. Everybody got their own little line, and it didn't really seem like too clunky or anything like that. It was just like, yep, all of our lives fucking suck. We're going to talk about why. and it was great. Yeah, wonderful, wonderful way to set the stage. And also just how ridiculous it was as well. Like, after you see that first number, I don't know if you're fully prepared for what's in store for the rest of it, but it gives you a decent idea. And yeah, that was very well done. I'm assuming it was a Tony's performance. They were up on stage and it looked like it was, you know, pro shot. So that was really cool. The quality wasn't great, but this was probably 2010, I would imagine, 2009. But the last person that came out, the guy that was like new to town, was like, you know, talking to the super, we will get to in a moment. But he looked really familiar. Like, I feel like I've seen him on stage in other things. So if anybody knows who the new guy is, or like what other things he's been in, please let me know that down in the comments. Because, yeah, it's going to bother me until I figure it out. But yeah, so back to the super. Gary Coleman? Why? Please tell me that he was in this. I can't remember when he passed. But yeah, like, why? Why Gary Coleman? Like, of all the people to lose all of their money, there's so many people. Why Gary Coleman? Is it because he's short? Like, I need to know. Robert Lopez, if you for some reason are watching this, first off, big fan. Second off, why? Why Gary Coleman? I mean, it was hilarious, don't get me wrong, but just came out of left field. But I'm assuming that that's probably going to be the overarching theme in this show, is just whatever you think it's going to be, it's going to be just completely different, but it's going to make you laugh. So yeah, this was wonderful. Thank you so much again, Mariana, for the request for the patronage. This was so much fun. If anybody else has any like favorite songs from Avenue Q, please put those down in the comments as well. I would love to take a look at more of this show. But otherwise, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in a reaction very soon.